Tornadoes can spin up real fast.
Yeah, there is. There is a bowl shape right there, no doubt. Can you see it?
Yeah, we are certainly watching for the threat of tornadoes later this week, but there's some brand new data coming in earlier this week about some pretty big research focused around tornadoes happening around the world, Michael.
Yeah, that's right. We're looking into them, Damon. Like, you know, when you think about it, these EF scale changes. So it's still going to stay the EF scale, but we do have some big changes. So the first question, how strong was it? That's one of the first questions people ask after a tornado. The enhanced Fujita scale, that's what we use to answer that question. And now it will be getting an upgrade.
As with everything, nothing's perfect. And there are a few issues with the enhanced Fujita scale that we have right now. Some of the damage indicators are inconsistent with each other.
Dr. James Ledoux, acting director of the National Windstorm Impact Reduction Program, is part of a team working on an upgrade to the EF scale.
The developers of the Enhanced Fujita scale never got foresters and ecologists and arborists together to really talk about that wind speed to damage relationship with trees. And we're doing that now.
The European Severe Storms Laboratory also has developed an international Fujita or IF scale that will be used in other parts of the world. It will include rating all types of wind damage rather than just tornadoes specifically.
Really be careful about that, because tornadoes have a wind profile that differs from just about anything else unless you're directly beneath a microburst.
Dr. Ledoux acknowledges that it would be good to have a scale for all types of wind damage, but tornadoes are still unique. Another change will be to use all methods to estimate wind speeds and rate tornadoes, including mobile radars.
What we're doing is we want to bring all methods to bear that estimate wind speed.
There's no specific timeline yet on exactly when the upgraded scale will take effect. But Damon, this is interesting because think back with me, May 31st, 2013, right? The El Reno EF3 tornado, a tornado like that, would now get an EF5 rating based on incorporating that mobile radar data.
You know, it's interesting to think that tornadoes can be controversial, but that tornado is probably the most controversial in the weather community, because we had EF5 winds, but there was not any EF5 damage. And so it went from an EF5 tornado to a couple days later being downgraded. But it did so much damage.
Yeah, it's tough to get an EF5 actually now, because they have to hit just a well-built structure, and the parameters are really tough to get now. So it's kind of interesting. It's kind of an apples and oranges database if you compare the old Fujita scale to the new enhanced Fujita scale.
Yeah, think about all the huge tornadoes that we see in the plains, but they're over the middle of nowhere and they get a very low rating. But that same tornado over a city would get a much, much higher rating.